This video is based on research paper writing. In this video, we will try to understand what is research process and how we can write research paper. So first, we will try to understand what is research paper, research process, research paper layout, and experiment's role in the research. So first, we will discuss what is the key tool used in the research paper. As we know, during Stone Age, humans communicate with each other using signs, signals, and you can see here pictures on the wall. And today we use language for the communication. Language, that is the structured system of communication, consists of written symbols, sound used by people for communication. So language is considered as the key tool in the research paper. Our aim is to publish the paper in the journal, and in journal we have different types of editors, also known as referee, that is native referee or non-native referee. Suppose we have two people, one is native speaker, another is non-native speaker, and they submitted the paper in the journal. Here you can see the native speaker paper is rejected due to poor writing skills. Here the paper is not rejected due to poor writing skills, what it is rejected due to poor readability skills. Here the referee cannot understand what he is trying to say, even the language is grammatically correct. See here we have two types of referee in the journal, native and non-native. Native editors check the paper flow and non-native referee will check the grammar mistakes, vocabulary mistakes. So we need to write in such a way both referees are satisfied. So we need to improve our writing skills. And if you want to improve our writing skills, you need to understand how people read. So use clear language and avoid complicated language and write research paper in such a way even non-expert or less experienced person can understand your research paper. Now, next question is, what is research paper? What idea or image comes in your mind when you hear this word research paper or research? Research means discover new knowledge. We are doing something in any area that will enable you to discover new knowledge. Simply, we are expanding our understanding of the world through research and pushing forward the boundaries of human knowledge. So learn something new that no one else knows and then writing about it so you can tell others what you have discovered through research paper. Now, next question is, what is knowledge? As we are trying to expand the limitation of human knowledge, so next question is, what is knowledge? So think about something that you strongly believe is true, but you cannot prove it. For example, just think about God's existence. If you believe in God's existence, still you cannot prove he exists. Or if you do not believe in the God's existence, still you cannot prove he does not exist. So knowledge is the combination of truth and belief. In research, we discover new knowledge and new truths, and we gather proof to support this truth. Now you can see here, this is the simple research process. First, observe any problem that you cannot solve with your current knowledge. After that, develop a hypothesis and then test the developed hypothesis and check whether it is true or not. Now you can see here we have different areas where we can research. For example, in computing, engineering, construction, medical, military, business, environment, psychology, robotics, space, science, and technology. There are significant differences how a medical research paper is written, how a space research paper is written, how science research paper is written, or how engineering research paper is written. But in whatever field you are in, rules of good research paper writing are same. Research paper should be clear, logical, and it should provide high level of readability. We can see here, this is the simple research process. First, analyze the problem and then develop the hypothesis. After that, test the developed hypothesis. After testing, analyze the results and draw the conclusion, and then write down the research paper and publish it. Now you can see here, this is the basic research paper layout. Title, that is the research paper title, author's name, abstract, keywords, introduction, literature review, methods, results, discussion, and conclusion. For the research paper, we have different section like its title, author name. Below author name, you can see here abstract, keywords, introduction, literature review, method, result and discussion, conclusion, and in the end, references. Now you can see here we have different fundamental pieces writing the research paper. First, we have title, abstract, introduction, literature, method, result, and conclusion. So first you can see we have title. Every single word in the title is important. It should make immediate sense to the readers or referee because it reflects your research work. What is the research paper all about? Reader can get the hint from the title about your research paper. Next, we have abstract. Abstract should be engaging, and abstract is like an advertisement for your research paper. It contains the summary of the research paper. After title, reader focus on the abstract as it contains research paper summary, and reader can get the basic idea about the research paper and your findings from the abstract. Next, we have introduction. Introduction is like the map for your research paper, and it should be focused and provide a map of the structure and content of the research paper. Next, you can see we have literature review. Literature review represents the other authors' finding for specific problem, results, their achievements, limitations. And when you're writing the literature survey, do not make any negative comment on the other author's work. Next, we have method section. It includes what you did, how you did, from where you obtained the material, and how you achieved your objective. And it should be unique than the previous work to prevent the plagiarism. Next, we have discussion and conclusion. It include your findings. In the discussion section, we combine the results together and discuss the hypothesis validation, whether it is true or not. And last, we have the conclusion section. Conclusion, sum up the main findings of your research paper. Now, next question is, what research is not? Research is not about information search. Its purpose is not to explain the subject. In research paper, we discuss and evaluate the research process. We require detailed information, accurate data, and we need evidence to support our beliefs. Next, you can see here the experiment's role in the research. First, we develop the hypothesis and then design experiments. After that, run the experiment and collect data from the experiments. Then test the hypothesis validation, whether it is true or not. Experiments are conducted to overcome the existing limitations and to verify the hypothesis whether it is true or not. Experiment results should be valid, verifiable, and useful. Verifiable means you will get the same results every time you run the experiment. And useful means results should be significant. If second time you run the experiment, it should make limited impact on the overall performance. So select a research paper and observe how paragraphs are linked together. Check author points in each section, how paragraphs are linked together, how result is connected with discussion, and how the conclusion is presented. Now you can see here we have different sections in the research paper. Now one by one, we will try to understand how we can write effective title, abstract, keywords, introduction, and literature. Now next we have keywords, how we can select the keywords for research paper. Just read your research paper, scan words, and then use 3 to 6 for the title and rest as the research paper keywords. So for example, you can see here we have a research paper title that is artificial gorilla troop optimizer, and you can see the keywords and the title words are same. Next we have title. So whenever you're writing the research paper title, avoid clever titles. It means whatever you have done in the research paper, the title should be related to that only. And it should be short and concise, and title should contain 3 to 6 words. It should be more informative, and it should make immediate sense to the readers. Whenever you're writing the title, delete the unnecessary words. So when you're writing the research paper, first make a rough structure for your research paper. It includes what you will write in the introduction section, how you will describe each topic in the research paper, how you will compare method X with method Y, and how you will combine the results. Next, you can see here how to write good abstract. First, make it clear that abstract is not same as introduction. It is just below the author's name, and it should be written after the completion of your paper, and it should be specific, short, and it should summarize the entire paper content, and it should include the summary of your findings. Next, you can see here, for example, here you can see they use just 6 lines for abstract. In the 6th line, first they mention the technique that they use, next about the research work, then they are doing the verification and comparison, in the end work, research work, contribution. Next is how we can write good introduction. So when you will start writing introduction section, just begins the introduction by briefly addressing two of the serve and most widely recognized gap in your knowledge. Introduction section should include what issue is your paper attempting to solve, what problems are researchers trying to resolve, their methods, results, and conclusion, and what significant issue will be covered in your paper. Introduction should be short, highlight the problems or issues that you are trying to resolve, and highlight the research paper aim. Also highlight the analysis and evaluation that must be performed, and your research work positive contribution. Describe the research paper main theme, goals, and provide relevant background. Describe your organization's plan, and avoid providing a lot of background on the author, and do not include the findings of your research work in the introduction section, and avoid presenting information that is not related to your research work. Now next is how we can write the literature review. Literature review include the researchers' findings, their methods, results, achievements, limitations. So first do the literature search before writing your research paper or performing research process. And in the literature section, avoid negative comments on the author's work. Now next, we will try to understand how we can write the method section, result section, discussion section, conclusion section, and references. First, we have method section. This section should be sufficiently detailed. Researcher in the related field should be able to reproduce the findings with enough accuracy. In the method section, avoid step-by-step instruction. Instead of that, you can provide references to the earlier work that include such information and also avoid unnecessary details. Make exact description on the noble technique. Next, you can see here result and discussion section. Result and discussion section should be short. Here, we discuss the results, how we achieved the results. In the discussion section, we explain the results. It contains a presentation of experimental results, your key findings, comparison. It indicates the results that are unique in a clear manner and not previously published. We can cite the previously published results. As you can see here, for the comparison, we are using the previously published research. So we can cite the results. Introduction and conclusion section include all essential inquiries related to your content, structure, methodology, topical focus, and your results. Conclusion section include the brief summary of the results and discussion. Briefly summarize the key findings, bring reader attention to the key issues, and provide a future perspective on the work and encourage reader for study on this issue. For example, you can see here for this research paper, the conclusion. You can see here we have just 6 lines. And in the 6th line, they briefly summarize the key findings. First line is about the proposed technique. Next line is about the research process. And here we have the results and comparison and future work. So next we have plagiarism. Plagiarism, that is the theft of diagram, ideas, or words. So in order to prevent the plagiarism, you can cite the sources here. You can cite the diagrams, ideas, or words. You can see here different citation. Next, we have references and citation. At the end of research paper, create a list of references, and references contain a list of each cited source in the research paper. And there should be citation for each item on the reference list. Here you can see we have 2 methods. Used for the citation. First is the British method. British method use number for citations. For example, you can see here the number, and this method is basically used in the conferences or in the journals. And advantage of using this method is it occupies small amount of space, and disadvantage is whenever you add or delete any citation, you need to renumber. Next is the Harvard method. Harvard method includes the author name and the publication year. And advantage is no numbering is required. In the references, give the following details: citation number and research paper details. And research paper details include author name, the year when the paper was published, research paper title, conference title, volume, and page number. So you can see here we have different for citation. We need different detail: author name, title, version, journal volume, issue volume, publisher, publication date, and URL. Now next we have figures and table. Figures and table are extremely important part of research paper. First, decide what data to present. And in the figure, you can represent the complex graphical data. And in the tables, you can represent the numerical data. And use table for specific information like exact values. Next, we have graph. Graph is used for data analysis. Reader can easily recognize the visual pattern. And graph must help to reveal the truth. And put the graph title information in the caption, and also explain every element that is used in the graph in the text. We can use bar charts for comparison. In the research paper, avoid any 3D effect in the table, figure, graph, because they are confusing.